used to post by the stove. Serve it like get it and go. Yeah. Clutching the toe in the poles, the trenches just me and my bro. Yeah, them bitches be stalking, but they wasn't calling me when I was broke. Yeah, she just gon' suck me and fuck me, then I'ma show her the dope. Yeah, cause I'm thumbing through them bands now. Cause I'm thumbing through them bands now. Now these niggas want a handout. Cause I'm thumbing through them bands now. Cause I'm thumbing through them bands now. Cause I'm thumbing through them bands now. VVS is I'ma stand out. I'm just thumbing through them bands now. I'ma just run up a check.
What's good, everybody? It's your boy Uncle Sam's Reject here, and welcome back to the USA Jags Dynasty. Now, as you guys can tell, my voice does not match the video you see on the screen. That's because I made a big mistake. I recorded this video with my mic on mute, but we are at home, Hancock Whitney Stadium here in Mobile, Alabama. We got three different recruits plus a little bit more coming in to visit. We need 100 yards rushing for two of them, and we need 250 passing yards for two of them. And as long as we can come out here and play our game against Tulane, I feel like we can come out here and get the job done. We have a strong recruiting class as long as we can get everybody to go ahead and sign. Take a look at Tulane's best players. Their three top players are all on their offensive line, so I think we may possibly have some trouble getting some pressure up front. We're 2-1 on the season. You know what I mean? Here, this is going to be our fourth game. We're 25 in the nation. We got our first SEC win. We had a real big nail biter versus the number 8 Oklahoma team last week. But, you know, as long as we keep on doing what we do, I feel like we'll be okay. On paper, we're better than them. Lee Corso's running with us. They got us beat in rush offense, rush defense, pass defense, and they're plus 6 in a turnover differential. Their quarterback, Barkley, 4 touchdowns, 0 picks, 276 yards. Hayes, 2 touchdowns on the ground with 200 yards. Their receiver, Taylor, 7 receptions, 86 yards, no touchdowns. Their top tackler has 6. Their top interception getter has 1, and their top sack getter has 1. And you take a look at our squad, but Barkley for Tulane is actually out with an injury. He's going to be going for the next 9 weeks of the season. So we're going to have to see the backup quarterback from Tulane, Jamar Johnson, where we didn't scout for him. We weren't really ready for him. They kind of hid Barkley's injury the whole entire week. But take a look at Tulane's schedule. They lost to FCS Northwest and came back and blew out Rice. And then us, we lost to Florida by one score, beat Ole Miss, and then we went ahead and took care of Oklahoma State last week. We're going to jump straight into this game. 3rd and 5 here in the first quarter. The junior hits Malik Kamara for a big first down. Malik Kamara came on last season, and he's kind of brought that into this season. And now we're going to, you know, trust into the run game. Trinilius Warfield with his first carry of the day. That's going to pick up 9 yards. We got to commit to the run in these games. As you see here, we try to get the ball to Aiden Bemis, utilizing his speed, getting out in space, picking up 6 yards there, boys. If we commit to the run, good things will happen. Now here's a 3rd and 8. Junior's back to pass again, and he throws an oopsie to the linebacker Bush, who was there to catch the pick. That is our first turnover of the day. Junior's 2nd pick of the season. Ron Bush, I mean, it was pretty much gifted to him. Junior was trying to fit that ball into a tight window, couldn't get it done. In the first play from scrimmage here for Tulane, Henry shoves one tackler. We trip over one of the offensive linemen, and on the first play from scrimmage, Henry is going for 6, and it is not looking good for the Jags right now. Courtney Henry and Jamar Johnson, those dudes are quick, they're fast, and we turn the ball. You know, we're forced to punt our 2nd drive of the day, and Johnson out in space on 1st and 10. He goes ahead and slides down, and here's 1st and 10. They go to a little screen to Henry, and once again, he goes beast mode, breaking a tackle, and he's just shy of picking up the first down there. 9-yard reception. He's killing this on the ground. He's killing this through the air. This kid is a pretty solid back. This time, he gets a toss out to the left. He breaks that one tackle, and he gets tackled a little bit short of the first down marker, but the refs are actually going to give him the spot there. And here's another speed option, and Hayes gets the corner. And just like that, your Jags are down 14-0 here in the first quarter. Now, we've been having slow starts this whole entire season, but we got to get it together here. Here's a 2nd and 10. Junior goes ahead and hits Jacob Hill on a nice little 13-yard out route. Keep them chains moving, and that's going to do it for us here. Well, I'm sorry. This is the last play of the first quarter, and we're going to hit Aiden Bemis, utilizing that speed, showing how electrifying he is, going get knocked down at the 30. It's a 33-yard pickup. Now, here's the first play from scrimmage here in the 2nd quarter. We hit Jacob Hill on a screen pass, and he's going to get into the end zone untouched. 30-yard touchdown pass from Junior to Jacob Hill. Jacob Hill, he has the skill set of a number 1 receiver, but he happens to play in the 2 spot for us, and he makes things happen out in space. Now, here's 14-7 here, 2nd and 11. in the second quarter. Tyrone Taylor catches a 9-yard pass there for Jamar Johnson. Now, here's a 3rd and 2. We commit to the run, and we get the stuff. No yards picked up there. Orlando Smith getting in the backfield, making a play, and we force a punt. Now, we know Aiden Bemis is absolutely dangerous in the return game. So he gets a little space here out to the left. He makes a man miss, makes another miss, tries to spin back. He's eventually brought down, but good thing about it, he switches fields for us. That's the 3rd and 9. Jacob Hill beats his man off the line, gets lit up, but Jacob Hill is able to hold on that. Now we're going to come back and hand the ball off to Aiden Bemis, and he's pushed out shy of the end zone at the 3. We're going to go right back to Hayden to Aiden Bemis. He utilizes his speed. He's in the end zone. We got 6, baby. We are an extra point away from tying up this ball game. 3:25 left here in the quarter. Now we skip ahead here. 2:34 left here with a bunch of penalties and miscues by Tulane. Here's a 3rd and long. We're trying to get the rush. We're taking everything away. Quarterback has all day, though. Eventually throws the ball underneath, but we're able to make a tackle there with Scott. Why are we back out in coverage with our D-tackle? We absolutely just can't rely on our computer counterparts sometimes. So we force another punt. Aiden Bemis back. You know what I mean? He has a lot of space. He had a good running start. They outkick their coverage. He makes a few misses. He cuts it back in. He has to make the punter miss. He does just that. 10-5. Touchdown, Jags. Aiden Bemis with the 66-yard punt return, baby. Let's go. And just like that, here at home, the Jags have all the momentum, boys. This is 21 points unanswered. Excuse me. 21 points unanswered here for the South Alabama Jags. Now, there's 1 minute left here in the half. Tulane trying to put a little drive together here, man. 2nd and long. Johnson back to pass. He pulls it down and runs. We're actually going to bring him down. It's just a 2-yard rush. We're here with a little no huddle. 3rd and 4. They try to do it again, and we bring Johnson down. And we're going to go ahead and call a timeout. 4th and 4. 36 seconds left. But we have the ability to make these plays. Here's Aiden Bemis cutting inside here with 22 seconds left. Of course, in college, the clock does stop. So, you know, we're back on the ball. Junior back to pass. He goes ahead and hits Malik Kamara. Malik Kamara spins in. He's unable to pick up the first down, so we are going to have to use our 2nd timeout. 16 seconds left here. Here's another handoff to Aiden Bemis. They're playing the pass. Oh, look at the moves. We got the blocks. But Jacob Hill misses a key block, and we're brought down inside the 30. 31-yard rush for Aiden Bemis. Now, here's Junior. Right there, you can see I pressed the pitch button, but he tried to pitch with his right hand. The ball was in his left. And we go up top to Greg Tarr. Next play. 5 seconds left on the clock. We strike for 6 more. Bang! 1 second left on the clock, but we were like, go hard or go home, and that's going to take us into the locker room up 14. We were down 14. Now we're up 14. That's what you call a 28-point swing, and we're going into the locker room up 14. Now here's starting off the 2nd half. We're in the backfield meeting Henry at the line of scrimmage. They hand it off to Henry once again, but this time he has amazing blocking. He picks up the first down. He has one man to beat. He's unable to make him beat. Alec Amon makes a tackle, but there's laundry on the field, boys, and it looks like it's going to be clipping on Tulane. It is coming back. Let's go. Big time break here for this defense. That's now a 2nd and 7, and then right on the next play, they pick up a false start. So this Tulane team is extremely undisciplined right now as Alec Amon comes up and lays the boom. 3rd and 6. 3rd and long. Where you want them to be? Jamar Johnson back to pass. He hits Cohen, and he's going to fall forward for the first down. Now here's another triple option for Johnson, but we eat that up in the backfield. That's a good tackle for loss. Our guy Rocky Matthews coming through making big-time plays. There's Damon Pop getting chop blocked. Can't make the sack. Johnson's going to get up out of there. He's across the 50. Down at about the 52. 3rd and 3 here for this Tulane squad. Now, right now, we're going to sell out for the run, and it's the right decision as we're able to stop Courtney Henry. He picks up 1 yard, but we stuff the run, and he's unable to pick up the first down. Now, we come back and hand the ball off to our guy, Aiden Bemis. Look at him showing off the moves, making people miss, but Greg Tartan Jr. lets us down. It doesn't block for his guy, and now on the next play, Jr. flushed out the pocket, showing off his wheels, and he's got a band on his heels, so he's just going to go ahead and get out of bounds. 33-yard pickup for the QB. 3rd and 10, we go to Jacob Hill. He picks up the first just shy of the 5-yard line. 165 on the day, 75 on the day for Jacob Hill. Junior back to pass, and it's a nice little screen to Greg Tartan Jr., baby. Bang! His 2nd tub of the day. 3 touchdowns to just 1 pick for Junior. That's his 5th touchdown of the season. And you know what time it is right now, boys. Get them 4s up. We got a 21-point lead heading into the 4th quarter. If we lose this game, we just absolutely do not belong, and, you know, we don't deserve any good fortune that may come our way. But here's 2nd and 8 here on the first play of the fourth quarter. Jamar Johnson, you know, pulls the ball down, takes off once again. That's an 18-yard pickup for Tulane. Trying to blitz him a little bit here, and come here! But we pick up the sack. Trey Hamilton with his first sack of the season. It's a big-time play. There's a 2nd and 10. Trey Hamilton nearly picking up an interception there. Jamar Johnson, those are his first two. That's his first, his second completion of the day. But here's a beautiful play call. Beautiful screen call on 3rd and 10 for Tulane. We do stop Henry short of the end zone. But on the very next play, Johnson pulls it on the read option, and he's in the end zone. And Tulane scores for the first time since the first quarter. Now, here we are, 1st and 10. Another handoff to Trey Warfield. And he nearly picks up the first down. 10-yard rush. Now, here's a play action. Junior back to pass, surveying the field. He's got Malik Kamara. That's a big play. He's down at the 25-yard line. 22-yard reception. That's our fourth plus third down conversion today. And look at that beautiful pass. An absolute dot from Junior. Drop that right in the breadbasket. And if you paid attention, Junior almost slipped there. Well, he slipped and almost fell due to the rain. And it comes up and delivers an absolute dime to Greg Tartan, who gets tripped up just out of the end zone. So we toss it to Aiden Bemis, and he's in the end zone. You know what time it is. We are just too much for this Tulane squad here today. 49-28 is going to be your final score. Aiden Bemis is the player of the game. 138 yards of total offense. Of offense. Two touchdowns. He had another kick. Punt return touchdown. Two big punt returns. 13 for 91. 2 for 47. 3 total touchdowns on the day. All-purpose yards off the charts, and he continues to be the igniter and the spark plug for us. Take a look at the score summary. 14-0 them. 28-0 us. 7-0 us. 14-14 in the fourth quarter. That gives us a 21-point victory. Team stats: Junior 16 for 29, 286 yards, 4 touchdowns, 1 pick, 55 completion percentage. Wasn't sacked at all today. Dipper Pines came in garbage time and missed three open receivers and goes over 3. On the ground, we already went over Bemis's numbers, but Junior 3 for 39 and Trey Warfield 2 for 19. Receiving, Greg Tartan Jr., 5 for 76, 3 touchdowns. Jacob Hill, 5 for 108 in a touchdown. Kamara Bemis, your Peoples, you know, they had 6 catches between the 3 with a decent amount of yards. Boylan and Boyd both pick up pancakes in the blocking game. Alec Amon leads in tackle, 7-6 solo. 5 loss solo for Trey Hamilton. Trey Hamilton also had the 1 sack. We did not catch any picks. We did not force any turnovers, but what we did catch was a big fat dub. And after that game, we go ahead and sign Brian Bailey and Cornelius Lewis. Both of those guys signed on the dotted line for the Jags. So we get 2 recruits, plus 750, plus 1,000, and plus 500 and all the others. And boys, we can't ask for much more. We're still ranked at 25 in the next week, but we're 3-1 and we're taking on 1-3 Rice. And I feel like we can come out here and get the best of them. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, man. If you did, stomp and smash that like button. Hit me up in the comment section below. Subscribe if you're new. It's your boy Uncle Sam's Reject, arcadegames.com. I'm out of here. Peace. Letting you go, I was just letting you know. I know the weather is cold, but you on your own. I ain't no regular Joe, you should have left me alone. I'm in the zone, I'm where the predators roam. We at the Senate in Rome, and I'm on the throne. This ain't no regular poem, this ain't that regular tone, no. Do you follow me?